Here's the back. Ibn Shman. Ibn Shah. Yourself. This occasion is not meant to be eulogies. It's meant to give fuel to the neshama to rise to the next level on its journey. However, in such a case, it would be remiss not to mention feelings about the family. I personally, and all the good things I heard about Estelle over the last month or so. 1955, I moved to the Ocean Parkway area. Everybody lived in this. And with a few boys there, we all became very tight and very friendly through the Ocean Parkway. In our famous home, PS215 School Yard, there was a, maybe it was a teenager, he was older. But the happiness people had when they entered the school yard, something good was going to happen, something fun, something exciting, something cheerful, and probably, maybe, excuse me, something nobody else would do. And I was a kid 10 years old, I used to look at him and say, who is this guy? And I could fast forward many years. I'm sitting in Slum Kettery. Not one of my best days. Anymore. I haven't seen him for a while. And he's with his good friend, and Bob Fesson, Jacob Yen, A.B. Harono. They walk into the room. How are you? How are you? Can I ask you a question? What are you doing? Here's a man who spent Sundays in the hospital. Visiting people he knows, people he doesn't know. But we have an SPH. He's MBH, Mr. Bigelow Clinton. Change your strength and help up me. I heard about Estelle. I heard about one of the brightest women this community ever produced. One of the most successful. One of the most well-liked. How many friends? Oh, I can't count. Too many. Maybe I'll tell you something. The Mara says, the legs of a person, take them to where they have to be at the end. And you, and your children, your dear wife, you can go through all the decisions that were made, and all the little moves to get that relatively young lady to that building on that. Everybody in the community feels for you. And more deeply than they would in a normal tragedy. Yaakov Avinu, for over 20 years, did not know where his son was dead or alive. I could never imagine that. But you made it real. Just not knowing. How did you not know? Yes, no, no. What is this time 11? Baruch Hashem, miracle science, new identity, prophet of Jewish burial. And without Hashem, the only place to get consolation is Shabbat. And that's why we say, you.
Torah tells us, "Banim atem l'Hashem Elokechem." You are the children of Borei Olam. You are the sons of Borei Olam. And then it outlines the halakha, very unusual. When somebody passes away, don't mourn excessively, and don't mourn like a goy mourns. A goy rips their flesh and scratches themselves. They impose pain on their physical body. You are not allowed. 30 comes, 11 comes, supposed to go on with life. Supposed to always feel, always love, and never forget. Lord to God to do. Don't mourn like a fool. What's the difference? Why is that a philosophical? Because it's the big philosophical difference about life and death between a Jew and anybody else on the planet. They believe that passing on what we call death is the end. And we look at it as a doorway. The same way a child came out of their mother's womb, and they cry right away. The lights, the people, the slapping. I was in such a good place. How could you take me out? The child grows. They learn to love this place. Ice cream and souffle, beach and fun, music and parties. The good things in life, Hagim, Shabbat. Then a person leaves. They don't leave. You had an offer on the bed. Now ask you, look into your IRA, see how much you can pay. Stay another day. Stay another week. Because we think this is it. The Torah teaches us this is not it. This is a hotel. This is temporary. A short time to take in the neshama that's raw and pure as a child and an infant, the newborn, and develop it into a complete human being. A beautiful character trait. With success in learning, keeping Shabbat, which she did, Kashrut, which she did, no matter where she was, she continued the tradition she learned in this beautiful home. That's why you're here. But everybody's here for a limited time. The neshama must live forever. But why in a hotel? Let's go to a mansion. Let's go to an estate where everything is beautiful and perfect. It's forever. You leave this world and go to a better world. When and why Hashem calls a person? But I can tell you, their job was done. What they came to accomplish is finished. It's time to move on. And the consolation, and I know it's good. Everything Hashem does is good. Everything. Sometimes it hurts. Sometimes it's bitter. Sometimes it's severe pain. But it's good. It's done for the benefit of the one suffering. We don't know. Gemara and Ta'anit 23b on the bottom where it gets long. I can see it now. Rav Mani was in the presence of a great rabbi. He told him, "Rabbi, I'm the Mishkid, I got a problem." He says, "What's that?" He says, "Hashem gave me a wife. Looks, you know." He says, "What do you want from me?" He says, "Pray to fix it, to do miracles." So he prayed, she became beautiful. Not only in his eyes, she's a beautiful woman. Stunning, we would say. Not too long after, he comes back to the rabbi. "Rabbi, can you pray for me again?" He says, "What do I know? Money? Business? What do I know? Bitcoin, what do you want?" Turn it back to the way she personality change. I can't stand her anymore. He thought it was good to have a beautiful wife. Hashem picked the right wife. So he tried again. Thank you. He comes back to the rabbi and says, listen, I got a problem. My in-laws are very rich. That's what you think. You're like him. He says, I got a problem with that. They're moetni, they kill me, they're so conceited, they're so overpowering, they're so overbearing. They think they should run my life. Could you make them poor? Bingo. Biden became president, they all lost their money. They lost their money. They became poor. He got his wish. So now he got a lama bond in this world. Wrong. Comes back to the rabbi. Rabbi, can you do me a favor? What now? Can you make them rich again? What? Every time my phone rings, it's one of them who needs money. I can't take it anymore. He thought the only wife was not good for him. She was. He thought the rich in-law was not good for him. He found out it was perfect. And he begged to get it back. One story I saw from the Kedah, the greatest rabbi in the last 500 years. He tells of a time when Harambam, which is about 1,000 years ago, was the great medical expert taking care of the Sultan in Egypt. And he had lines of people when he came home at night, like his full day taking care of the palace, because he was the expert doctor of the world. The Ibn Ezra, another Sephardic study, read what this Harambam wrote, because I have to meet this man. He was very, very poor. Whatever he could do to travel, he finally arrived at the palace when the Rambam was leaving. He caught him leaving work. The Rambam was coming to the crowd. He looks, see that man? He points at Ibn Ezra. He tells the guy's guarding him, he's leaving the palace. Take him and lock him in a cave, in a dark room with no lights. And don't feed him. And don't tell him how long he's going to be there. And say, oh, he's in every room watch. So they do it. He's in there, so what happened? I came to see Harambam. And here I am locked up. He starts to cry. Crying. They tell Harambam, poor guy, I don't know what he did. Nobody. There's proof. He says, okay, take this bowl. He's not a bowl. Take this bowl and tell him, when he fills this bowl with tears, I'll let him out. Strange request. So he cries more. Gotta get out of here. Finally, it's full of second time. And he's coming. Comes at dusk. How are you? What do I have to do there? So I told him, like, nothing ever happened. He said, Rabbi, do you know you just did to this man? He says, yes. So why'd you do it? So I looked at him in the crowd and I saw he had an eye disease that had become blind in a very short time of life. And I knew the cure for that is the salt water of tears. And if he cries enough, he can save himself. What looked bad? For who? We don't understand what Harambam meant. I'm sure you're wondering why. How can we understand what Hashem meant? An egg on the ground is closer to our brain than our brain is to Harambam. Forget what it is. You can't feel it. Tamim tiyeh Hashem Elokecha. Walk with pure faith. He did it, it must be. He did it. There's no other choice. And he only did good. He did it for me, the one son. This is the attitude we have to take. This coming Saturday night was the issue about Rosh Chodesh Elul. So many times, especially in the last year, people look. We all cried. We all heard Hashem Shofar blow. We got back on ourselves. Can't let this go away. This is a shofar. It's a shofar echad and a habura. If somebody in a group leaves, everybody has to ask themselves to God. We're all related to this material. We're all related to this family. We're friends, community members, we're caring people who came here today. You should all know we have to take it. Can't let it pass. Time will come, they'll shave. Doesn't matter. We have to look at them and remember. We have to think to ourselves and remember. Elul is here. This was decided last Rosh Hashanah. The next Rosh Hashanah is another law of 30 days. Just for that. That's a big number. 34 days of waiting and one day of waiting. We're that close to Rosh Hashanah. Shofar is blowing, and the Har Sinai lo pasach. The Har Sinai and Shofar blew the whole time. It didn't stop. Not like we blow in shul. We go out for a walk. This shofar should not stop blowing. Everybody should say, I'm going to fix me. I'm going to prevent the need for any more tragedies, for any more shofarot, for any more unhappy families suffering, in doubt at first and in pain afterwards. But the final result. We should take part in their suffering and use it the way Hashem intended. Et Hashem Yerachem Hashem Mufil. The person Hashem loves is the one who chooses discipline. Thank you so much. Beautiful.